Hello, hello, everybody. It is 4:09 p.m. Central Time on Saturday, August 5th, 2017. And I'm just jumping on here to let everybody know, in case you didn't catch it yesterday, we have switched our live update times back to 10 p.m. Central Time, 11 p.m. East Coast Time, 8 p.m. West Coast Time. I think somebody said it's 3 p.m. New Zealand Time. Or no. Is that right? No, it can't be. It's a daytime and nighttime for over in the West Pacific and over in Europe. So, in case you don't know, again, one more time, we are doing our updates at 10 p.m. But I do want to jump on real quick, let you know, there has been some activity today that we do want to talk about. And look at the United States, for instance, here in Oklahoma and up in Kansas. New swarm activity breaking out starting yesterday. Additionally, up at Yellowstone, really, really starting to stack up on top of each other. And that's all going up into the 3 range in the park. Over here to the west, take a look at the west coast, also in the 3 range. 3.1 seems to be the number of the day. And that goes back, it traces all the way back up to the northwest coast. And I want to show you guys something here. Just check this out. Look at this. Oh, not the storm. Hold on. Let's go over to the real-time tremor map. Look at the real-time tremor map over the last 24 hours. Look at this. Washington, Oregon, Northern California, all swarming with tremors, all associated with the slow slip that the professionals said stopped back in April. We know it didn't stop. You're seeing it right here before your eyes in 24 hours. Let's look at 48 hours worth of events. Then you really start to see it. And this is a noteworthy increase. We had a couple a week ago where there was just a spattering of maybe 3 or 4 events. 3 or 4. Now look how many there are. I mean, there's just, you know, we're going in the number of hundreds going up through California into Oregon. So that's really interesting to see happen. Now let's go over to the Volcanic Ash Advisory Center. Quickly check in on that. See if we've got anything going on. Oh, yes, we sure do. How about Manam Volcano erupted? Now, guys, this is all the way over here in the West Pacific, but this is part of the update. We issued a warning yesterday talking about this being the silent zone in Papua New Guinea, and I raised the possibility of Manam Volcano suddenly sending off a new blast. Now, I don't forecast eruptions normally, but apparently we just did because it just got hit, and it's been a while. So, Manam, it's been weeks, if not a month or more, since any activity being reported on the Volcanic Ash Advisory Center. And, of course, today, a new blast centered in between the previous sets of 5s that we talked about yesterday. Also on the list, we've got Bagana and Reventador and Ulawan. So the Papua New Guinea is just going through the roof with eruptions. Ulawan, Bagana, Manam. I mean, this is a big increase across this area. So let's just, again, show that to you again one more time. Manam, Ulawan, and Bagana all through here. And this is the spot where we're looking for the potential of a 6 to 7.0 earthquake in the next couple days or less. I would also like to point out to my viewers down in New Zealand, last night there was a 4.2? Was it a 4.2? At Taupo Volcano. And take a look at what just happened in the past few hours. A new 4.2 striking at the center part of New Zealand. So New Zealand, we can check that off the list. It was hit as expected the day after I canceled the warning. Day after I canceled the warning. I mean, what can I say? You got a 4 to your north, you got a 4 at central. It's taken a minute for it to happen. That's the only difference, building into a larger event. And it could go up. That's 2 4.2s in the last day. That's an increase. To go from 2s to 4s, that's a 100-fold increase in power. And both earthquakes, one at Taupo, one at the plate boundary. Now, also looking around the other plates, let's go over towards Europe. Take a look at what's happening over there today. Yesterday's 4.0 struck at Lesbos Island. Today, the Adriatic Sea, North Italy at the Swiss border, or Switzerland at the North Italy border, more like it, and then going up into France. All happening today, okay, to last 24 hours. So since the 4, look going right across. Oh, and one other earthquake. Here, hold on. Striking at central Greece. So 2.9 activity, 3.0, striking at central Greece right here. And then the Aegean Sea, also 3.0. Just have to throw that in there. So 2.4, striking halfway across. And then going up to the north, you have your 2.0 activity up at the Swiss border. Elsewhere, where else do we need to talk about? How about Central America really quick? Just looking at the fours from yesterday. Where are they? There they are, marked in red. And then going into today, look, 4.6 and a 4.1 in between the previous fours. So the fours got hit with a combination of the total amount of, I think there was four different fours and maybe even some threes and twos that we didn't get to see reported. And if you take those together, it would go into, let's say, 4.2 to 4.3. And here's a 4.6. So it's just a couple points off from the exact total of everything that hit. So I want you to imagine that you get a, you know, 100 different small earthquakes add up to a single larger earthquake. And in this case, we have multiple fours adding up to a single larger 4.6. So the larger we go, when you add them together, the larger it gets. Makes sense, right? Now down to the south, we have something else going on. Reventador volcano here at Ecuador continues to erupt. Sanjay stopped erupting. So just Reventador erupting at Ecuador over and over and over and over again all this week. And that's an increase. So we have to watch in this area when the volcano finally stops, there's going to be a new noteworthy sized earthquake next to Ecuador. That could go up towards Colombia or down to the south towards the Peru border. It should all happen in the next few days. That volcano cannot keep erupting without seeing a new earthquake happening either after the erupting stops or in between the eruptions. There's going to be plate boundary deformation thanks to this one. And it's going to be larger. How big? Most likely a combined total of the total amount of eruptions. Each eruption equals about a 5.0 earthquake. So let's say there's been six eruptions. That's just a rough guess off the top of my head, but it sounds about right. So six eruptions in the last week at this volcano, maybe five, maybe four, but somewhere in that range. So six fives, basically. Six 5.0 earthquakes equals 5.6. Literally rough addition. Every five you add on adds another point. So 5.6 would be due at the center. And anything above five at this location can and has, in the past few months, caused fatalities. We don't want to see that. So I'd rather have the people there know the reason you're going to get hit is because the volcano is deforming the plate boundary right now with all those eruptions. Finally, getting down to the south portion of South America, no new noteworthy activity to report to you today, so far. Now we're watching for pressure to transfer down around and underneath and come back up at the South Sandwich Islands fairly soon here. Not that big of a deal. I don't think anybody lives there. It's just something to watch for on the earthquake forecast. All right, so New Zealand, look, I mean, what can I say? You guys got hit. West Coast, Midwest, U.S., you guys got hit. We've been watching this spread across the plates. Slow slip happening in the Northwest. That's a big deal. Okay, so you just got to start taking it all together. That this is all happening in conjunction with one another. And I haven't even gotten into the microquakes in California or the volcanoes or the nuclear test sites or anything else. We'll talk about all that tonight at 10 p.m., going to save this as a video on my channel as a generalized update for everyone to share and just understand what's going on right now. Again, today is August 5th, 2017. It is now 4:17 p.m. Central Time, and we will wrap this up. Word up to my people. And guys, the 4x4 fundraiser, we decided not to do it. So, I was doing it to try and, you know, kind of stick it in the eyes of the trolls. That's not ever a good reason to really do it. If I need a truck, I'll buy one. I'll sell my military glass. I'll do a big auction and get rid of my stuff. I got a bunch of cameras. We could, you know, I can autograph cards for people. And if I ever need to get that kind of stuff, do a fundraiser to spite the trolls. And I've done it before and it worked great. But look, I mean, you guys are supporting me on Patreon. I don't need a truck that much. I do, but I don't. I do. Don't get me wrong. We do. We're living out here in the country, but I don't need you to pay for it. So I can do that. It'll be, you know, down the road a little bit. No pun intended. Down the road a little bit, I'll be buying a truck. But my Volvo is going to get fixed, and it's got 200,000 miles on it. I hope it'll make it to 220 or 250. I'm going to drive that sucker into the ground. I'm such a sting when it comes to spending. So I will drive my car till it falls apart. Glamour and luxury are not words that are in my... This house that we're in now is the nicest place I've lived in. And that's not thanks to me. that's not my luck. Again, we're renting, so... But anyways, yeah, word up. So the fundraiser for the truck, while it sounds fun, and I started it on GoFundMe, I turned it off immediately. I'm sure somebody's going to make a video and freak out anyways. That'll be great. They probably already did. Like, the trolls already went up and freaked out and everything, and like, I already got them now. You know, they're going to make their video and put it up. It doesn't even exist. And you know what? Nobody should have a problem with me trying to raise funds for a truck to do earthquake studies, to drive out in the back countries, when my biggest observers, right? He raised $100,000 for a Winnebago to drive around the country and meet people. To drive around the country and socialize, right? So, you know, nobody had a problem with that. Maybe I just need to get a Winnebago, but that's not four-wheel, man. I can't drive it in the back country. What good is having a Winnebago when you need to drive up to that volcano back there, or when you need to drive on that muddy road to that frack well, or where the earthquake struck out in that farm field? Right? That's the idea here. So, but if I need that, I'll go buy it. I'll figure out a way to do it. And if I need your help, I'll come to you. But, yeah, we're all good right now. So... Okay, word up. Peace out. Much love. Hey, by the way, guys, this coming week, I'm getting a high-speed line installed. So I'll be one of the first people here in this community to have real, true high-speed internet. Once that's installed, we're getting cameras put in down at the lake with a pan-tilt zoom night vision up to 800 feet camera. And we're going to install it down by the dock. So we can get sunrises, so we can get sunsets. It's got motion tracking on it, automatic. So if it detects moving objects, like those boats going by, it'll track them if we want. Otherwise, we can control it too. I can put up the controls and maybe even figure out a way to get the controls on my website. So that if you guys wanted to, maybe if you wanted to control the camera and zoom it yourself, you might be able to do that. We'll see if that's possible. If it's not possible, I'll still be able to control it and zoom it and get in different spots. That's going to be really cool. Secondly, it's got night vision and it's got star tracking. So we can do star tracking with it, and that is incredible. So we'd be able to capture fireballs. We've got meteor showers that are great that are captured out here. It's like pitch black at night on a lake. So that will be really cool. Then also, it'll be installed, hopefully in time, for the solar eclipse. So when the solar eclipse happens, we are here west of St. Louis, in between St. Louis and about halfway in between St. Louis and Columbia, Missouri. So maybe a little bit over half. And so should be able to capture it. That's where the center of the eclipse is going to be, right over central Missouri at that time at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Oh, look, we got a little kayaker there. Two kayakers. Hey, who are they? Ah, you know what? Anybody got a canoe or a kayak they want to sell?